Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. I expect that you remember what has been taught to you and that you will be able to use it whenever you need to. In this class, you will practice what you had learned earlier and will also learn something new. As you know, in the first class of the week, you learn something new and the next class is for revision. Whatever you have learned so far in spreadsheet is a very important part and you will be using this in future for your office work. As such, this will be very useful for you. Before we begin today's class, let us revise what we have learned so far. Can you tell how you select two or more pictures in one go? To select two or more pictures in one go, you will go to the Format menu and get to Group option and make these pictures in a group. After this, when you click on one picture, the whole group of pictures gets selected. Can you tell why is the link to external option used? Using the link to external option, you can link the range defined in any sheet and insert it on the sheet. Can you tell what happens with the flip option? Using the flip option, you can rotate your objects. This can be of two types, horizontal or vertical. Can you tell what is the difference between SUMIF and SUMIFS? You use SUMIF when from a given data you want to get the total or sum based on one condition. You will use SUMIFS formula when from a given data, you want to get the sum or total based on two or more than two conditions. Can you tell why we use the COUNTIF and COUNTIFS formula? You will use the COUNTIF formula when you want to get a count from a row or column of some data using one condition. You will use the COUNTIFS formula when you want to get the count from a row or column of some data using two or more conditions. What syntax will you use to get the largest and the smallest value from your sheet data? For largest value, you will use the syntax is equal to large bracket begin number list semicolon n bracket close, and for the smallest value you will use the syntax equal to small bracket begin number list semicolon n bracket close. Can you tell why is the match formula used? Using the match formula, you can match any data value from your sheet to a given value. For this, the formula you use is equal to match bracket begin search criteria semicolon lookup array semicolon type and then bracket close. Now all of you switch on your computers and using any of the methods taught to you, open your file. Let us now begin today's class. In today's class, you will all revise the options of the View, Insert and Format menu learned during the last class and will practice using some formulas. Next, key in data on your spreadsheet or look at the given data in front of you and type in this data on your sheet. You can make columns for employee name, ID, and any other information which you would like to use. Now, All of you practice using the formulas you learned in the last class one by one. Now show how you will use the match formula to match the data in your document to a given value. And watch the video to learn more about this. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the match formula. So we have typed, we already have some data on this CALCI sheet, and we have typed ID in one cell and position. So we type some ID which is in this table, in this data, and we want to find the position. So the ID we have chosen is 344. To find its position in our data, we use the position formula. We use the match formula. So we will type equal to match match begin bracket, and then the search criteria, which is 344. So we select that ID, semicolon, and then lookup array is the ID column. So we select the ID column, and then type is 0, semicolon 0, close the bracket. And when you press enter, you find that the position for 344 is 3. So you can see in the third row, this ID appears 344. So this is how you can use the match formula. Now, from your data, show how you will get the total based on any one name. If you face a problem in doing this, then watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, we are now going to see how we can use the SUMIF formula to add some data for one specific name. So as you can see in the video, we have some data already for different names, and we have chosen the name Akash, for whom we want to find the total of any one of our datas. So we use the SUMIF formula equal to SUMIF, begin the bracket, and then select the range. So the range is the names column. So we select that, semicolon, and then the criteria is that we are looking for Akash, the name Akash. So we select that, put semicolon again, and then select the range. So we just want to find the value for Akash in Gurgaon column. So we select that, close the bracket, press enter. And you can see that there are three names which are the same Akash name. So what SUMIF formula is doing is that it is totaling the values given in Gurgaon column for Akash name, which is 4000 plus 4501 and plus 4505, and it is giving you the total here. So this is how you will use the SUMIF formula with one condition. Now use any one name and based on it show how you will get the average. Again, if you have any doubts in finding this average, then watch the video and learn from it. By watching this video now, we're going to see how we use the average if formula to get the average of some data for one given condition. So we already have some data on our CALCI sheet, and let's say we want to find the average value for one name, Akash. So we have typed that name here. We will be using the average if formula. So we want to find the average. So we are writing the title average here. And we will apply the formula here. Now you can see in this data, the name Akash appears three times. So from whatever values we select, from whatever data we select, average if formula will find the average of the three values which appear in front of the name Akash. So we are going to use the data for Gurgaon and apply the average if formula. So the average if formula will be equal to average if, begin the bracket, then it says range. So the range is the names column. So we select the names column, semicolon, and then the criteria. So we're looking for average of Akash. So we select Akash as the criteria, semicolon, and then select the range from where we want the average. So we are selecting the Gurgaon data range, as can be seen in the video, and close the bracket. Once you close the bracket and press enter, you can see the average value of the three data figures for Gurgaon for the name Akash appear here. So you have 4336.3333, which is the average value for this name from the Gurgaon data. So this is how you will use the average if formula for based on one condition. Now show how you will count how many times a particular name appears in your data. If you face a problem in doing this, then learn from the video. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the count if formula to count how many times a specific name is appearing in our data. Since we already have some names, let's just copy paste these names here, the names which are not repeating. So the top five names we have just copied and pasted here, and then in the next column we want to find the count of, let's say, Akash, how many times it appears in our data, how many times Amit appears, how many times the other names appear, Arun. So we'll use the COUNTIF formula here. We will write equal to COUNTIF, begin bracket, the range is the names range, so we select that, semicolon, and then the criteria. For criteria, first we are choosing Akash. Choose that, close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that in this name range, it appears thrice. The name Akash appears thrice. Similarly, if you want to apply the same formula for the others, you will just drag this down, the black dot down, or double click on it, and you can see that the names Arun appears twice. Similarly, Suraj, Sachin appear twice, and Amit appears once. This is how you will use the COUNTIF formula for one condition. Now, show how you will get the average from your data for any one entry whose name and ID is the same. If you face a problem in finding the average, then learn how to do so by watching the video. We will watch this video now to find how we use the average ifs formula where there are two conditions, like the same name and the same ID appearing for the data that we have. So we want to apply the average ifs formula. So we will use equal to average ifs, begin the bracket, and then we will select the range from where, from the data, from where we want the average to be found. It could be the data in Gurgaon, Pune, Delhi, Bangalore, or the total data. So if we want to get the average from the total data, we will select the totals column. So we have selected that as our range. Put a semicolon. Now there are two conditions. The name and the ID should be the same. So for the same name, for the same ID. So after the semicolon, we select range 1, which is the name, names column, put a semicolon, and then the criteria here is that we want to find the same name of Akash. If Akash appears many times with the same ID, that is what we want to choose. So we've selected this range, the criteria being Akash. So we select Akash, put a semicolon, then the range 2. So the range 2 is the IDs column. So we select the IDs column or the ID data. Select that. Put a semicolon. And now the criteria would be that the ID should be 123, which is the ID for Akash. So you can select that ID 123, close the bracket and press enter. So as soon as you press enter, it looks for all the Akash names which have the same ID 123, and then from the total it gives you the average. So as you can see in our data, the first name and the last name, which are both Akash, have the same ID 123. From their total data is 20503 and 18026. So the average of this is found and given back to you by use of the average ifs formula. Now, all of you insert the DOB, date of birth, in any column and find the days for each of these in the format of Sunday, Monday, etc. Let us watch this video and see how these are calculated. Let us watch this video now and see how from given date or date of birth, as is the case in this data, we can find the name of the day. For this, we will be using the text formula. So in this case, in the given data, we already have date of birth. So in the next column, we are just typing the title day's name, because we are going to find out the name of the day from a given date. So for this, we are going to use the text formula. So we type equal to text, begin the bracket, and then select the number or the date from which we want to find the day. Then give the format. If you want it to appear in full, then we will type in inverted commas, double inverted commas, DDDD, 4 times D. Close the bracket. If you want short form, you will type DDD, 3 times D. Close the bracket and then press enter. So you will see that it returns the day as Monday. If you want to find the day of all the other dates, you can just double click on the small dot in the right side or drag it downwards, and you get the days for all the date of births given in your data. So this is how you're going to use the text formula and find the name of the day from a given date. Next, all of you show how you will get the largest and smallest value from your data. If you face a problem in getting these values, then watch the video and see how it is done. Let us watch this video now and see how from a given data we can find the largest and the smallest value and the next largest and the next smallest value. So we can find the ranks of these values. So what we are doing in the video is we are typing rank 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then let's find the maximum value first. So for maximum value, we will use the, let's use the max formula. So we can just type equal to, and we are going to find the these values from the total data. The maximum total, the next maximum total, and similarly the smallest total and the next smallest total. So we type equal to max, begin bracket, and then select the range. So we select the total values, that column, and then close the bracket, press enter, and you can find the maximum value is given to you or is shown to you. Now if you want to find the next maximum, you will use the large formula. So we type equal to large, begin bracket, select the range. So again we select the totals range, and the rank, we select rank 2 now after the semicolon, close the bracket, and you find the next largest value. And then if you drag down this formula, it gets applied to rank 3, rank 4, rank 5. So you find the largest value, the next largest, and so on till the fifth largest value. Next, let's find the minimum value, the least value from our total data. So we'll use the minimum formula here, equal to min, M-I-N, begin the bracket, then the range, which is the totals range, and then just close the bracket, press enter, and you will find that the minimum value is shown, 16,707. Now, if you want to see the next minimum to that, we will use the small formula. So, we use equal to small, begin bracket, select the data range, which is the totals range, we select that, then a semicolon, and then the rank is 2 in this case, so we select the rank from here, close the bracket, press enter, and you see the next smallest value after 16,707 is 18,026. And if you copy this or drag this formula downwards, you will get all the other minimum values also. The third minimum, the fourth minimum, the fifth minimum. So this is how you will be using the small and large formula. Next, show how you will get the total from your data for the entries whose ID and name are the same. In case you face a problem in getting the sum, then watch the video and see how this is done. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the SUMIFS formula to find the total data for a given name. SUMIFS we are going to apply for two conditions. We are applying the conditions being the name should be the same and the ID should also be the same. So for this we will use the SUMIFS formula. So let's write SUMIFS here so that we can get the SUMIFS and we can use the SUMIFS formula. SUMIFS, where there are two or more than two conditions, we use SUMIFS formula to find the totals. So we are going to find the total for Akash, whose ID is the same, 123, and then from the total data, we want to find the total for these two Akash names. So we type the formula equal to SUMIFS, begin the bracket, and then the sum range is the totals range. So we select that from this total column, semicolon. Then our first condition range is the name range. So we select that. And the criteria is that the name should be Akash. So we are selecting the name Akash. As you can see, we select the name Akash from here. Put a semicolon, and then the next condition is the related to the ID. So the next range will be the ID column. So we select the ID column after putting a semicolon here. Range 2 is the ID range. This is the second condition. And from this, the criteria is that the ID should be 123. So, we will get the total of the total data for Akash whose ID is 123. So, if there are two names appearing with the same ID, the total will be given. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that the first name Akash and the last name Akash have the same ID, 123. So, their total value, which is 20,503, plus 18,026 is shown here as 38,529. If you drag this formula down, you will get the same for Arun Suraj. However, if you notice, the name Arun appears with different IDs. So only the first ID of Arun, similarly the other names appear with different IDs. So only one data is being shown here for each of the other names. So this is how you will use the SUMIFS formula for two conditions or more than two conditions. Now, show how from amongst your data, you can get the count of the entries which have the same name and ID. Watch the video to see how such a count can be done. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the COUNTIFS formula, where we use more than one condition. For instance, from the data given, we want the same name having the same ID to be counted. So we will use COUNTIFS. So we have just typed the title here. In the next cell, we are going to key in the formula. And the formula to be used is equal to COUNTIFS. Remember, it has to be COUNTIFS. There is a S in the end. COUNTIFS, begin the bracket. It asks for the range. The first range is the range is the names. From the names, we want to find which names are similar, having the same ID. And we want a count of those. So we select the names column as the first range. As you can see in the video, we select this range 1 as the names column. Put a semicolon. Then you want the criteria. The criteria is that the name should be Akash. One of the names which we want to see how many times it is repeating, but with the same ID. So there are two conditions that we are using. After the selecting the name as a criteria for range 1, put a semicolon, then select range 2. Range 2 is the ID. That is the second condition that should be matched. So we select all the IDs in the ID column, put a semicolon, and then select the ID for Akash, which we want to see the count for. We want to see a count for the same name having the same ID. So we select 1, 2, 3 as the criteria 2 for our COUNTIFS formula. So we select that, close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that although there are 3 times the name Akash is appearing, but the third name of Akash has a different ID. The name Akash with the same ID 1, 2, 3 appears twice. So that is why the count is 2. Now if we drag this formula down by clicking, double clicking on this dot or dragging it downwards, you can see that the COUNTIFS formula counts the names, other names having the same ID, but they appear only once. So that is why the count for Arun, Suraj, Sachin and Amit is only 1. There are no 2 names amongst this which have the same ID. That is why the COUNTIFS formula is giving us 1 as the answer for the other names. This is how you use the COUNTIFS formula. Next, make any picture and show how you will do some formatting on it. Let us watch this video now and see how we can insert an object, a picture. So we are going to the tool, drawing toolbar. We select a shape and drag it on our Calci sheet. Once you have dragged this shape, you can see that the line and filling toolbar also appears whenever you have an object or an image. So you can now use the line and filling toolbar to format this shape. So if you want, you can change the outline color as is being shown in the video. And then if you want to add some color inside this image, inside this object, you can do so. You can select a color of your choice and the color changes. So this is how you will add an object or an image and format.
Now show how you can rotate this picture and also tell in how many ways you can rotate the same. Let us now watch the video.
Let us now see how we can rotate this picture. So we already have a picture in our Calci sheet. We select that, then take our pointer to the format menu, click there, click on flip, and let's click on flip vertically first. So you can see that the picture has been vertically flipped. Again, if you want to use horizontal flip, you have to select the picture,
go to format menu and click on flip object horizontally, and you can see the horizontal flip has also happened. So this is how you can use the flip option for these pictures. Now show how you will create a group of all these pictures and also say what happens when you do this. Watch the video to learn more about this. In this video, let us now see how we can group pictures together on our Calci sheet and work on them. We already have one image, one object on our Calci sheet. We use the drawing toolbar and drag one more object here. So if you like, you can format it, change the color if you want for the second object also. Now to group them, we need to select both these objects. So you have to hold the shift key down and select the first object, keep the shift key down and select the second object. Now go to the format menu, click there, click on the group option and then click on the group option from there. So now these objects are in a group. So if you select one, both the objects get selected. If you move them together, they will move. So now they are in a group. So any formatting that you do, any change that you do will happen on both the objects. You can see in the video, we are changing the format, we're changing the color of the object and it gets changed for both. If you want to ungroup them, select them, go to format, go to group and click on ungroup. Now if you select these objects, they will get selected one by one. And any changes that you make on one will get applied to only that object. This is how you can group or ungroup objects on your Calci sheet. Next, show how you will make the heading of your data bold, italic, and also underline the same. Note that the alignment for all should remain center aligned. Now, watch this video and learn how we can make some text on our Calci sheet and change the format to bold, italic, underline and also align it centrally. So we have selected the first row, the title row, where the name, ID, email, date of birth, etc. are written. Then we just, in the formatting menu bar, we click on B, it becomes bold, we click on I and U, the icons which are there, and it becomes italics and also gets underlined, as you can see, as is being shown in the video. Now you can also see that these are all left aligned. If we want to do central align, we need to select them and we can directly use the icon in the formatting bar or go to the format menu, click there, click on the alignment option and select central alignment. As you can see in this video, alignment and then central alignment, and you can see that all the text has been centrally aligned. So this is how you can format any text on your Calci sheet, make it bold, italic, underline and centrally aligned.
Save this file. Now go to another sheet and key in some data. Next, all of you key in the following values in a column. 1220, 2233, 20000, 322, 329, 33, 231, and then also say which of these values are even. Let us watch this video next.
Let us watch this video now and see how we can find out the even data from our Calci sheet. The data which is already available on our Calci sheet, we can find out if it is even or not. So for that, let's first go to the sheet 2. Let's type out a title here, numbers. And then in the next column, let's type out the title even. We will type the numbers which were just shown to you and then we will find out if they are even or not. So type out the numbers. You can see the video and you can also type out the same numbers on your calci sheet. The first number is 1220, then 2233, then 20,000, then 32329, and the last number we are typing here is 332231. Now, if we want to see if this number is even or not, we can use the even formula, equal to even, and then begin the bracket and select the number. So we select this 1220, close the bracket. But the even formula, if the number is not even, it adds a number to it and makes it even. So since we want to find out whether a given number is even or not, we will use the is even formula. So that is what we are doing now in the video, equal to is even, begin the bracket, then select the number, close the bracket, press enter, and if it is an even number, which 1220 is even, you will get true written there. Now you can drag this formula down by either dragging this black button down or double clicking on it, and you can see that 20,000 is also an even number, so true is written, but for the other numbers which are odd, false is written. This is how you can find out for any data if the number is even or not.
Now, all of you find the LCM and GCD for 23, 53, 42, 56, 34, 23, 76 and 88. Let us watch this video and see how the LCM and GCD are used.
Let us watch this video now and see how we can find out the LCM and the GCD from given set of numbers. So since we want to find the LCM and the GCD of some numbers, let's first type the title numbers on our sheet here and then just let's key in all the numbers. So in the next cell we type 23, then 53, 42, 56, 34. These are the numbers which were given to you. After 34 is 23 again, 76 and 88. So now we want to find the LCM. So let's key in the title LCM, and in the cell where you want to find the LCM for these numbers, select that cell and let's type the formula. You have to start with an equal to sign, as with all formulas. So equal to LCM, begin the bracket, and then the numbers. So you can just select all the numbers, close the bracket, and press enter. So this big number is the LCM, or the least common multiple for all these given numbers. Next, we also want to find the highest common factor, or the GCD, greatest common denominator. So we apply the formula, equal to GCD, begin the bracket, and then select the numbers. So once again we select these numbers, close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that the GCD for all these numbers is the number 1. So this is how you can use the LCM and GCD formula to find out LCM and GCD.
Since we will end today's class here, all of you save your file and then close the same and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class,
you revised what you learned in yesterday's class and practiced the use of some formulas like SUMIF, SUMIFS, COUNTIF, COUNTIFS, AVERAGEIF, AVERAGEIFS, SMALL, TEXT, GCD, IS EVEN, IS ODD, etc. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.